Fishin' Affliction. Hello.
Well, Mom and Dad's grab the kids, it's time for the fishing show. Me and old Rusty's gonna go catch them down at the fishing hole. Well, you better stick around, cause you don't know what you're missing. Yeah, me and old Rusty's got that fishing affliction. Grab your hats, grab your baits, and don't forget your poles. We're gonna fire up that old Ranger boat and head to the fishing hole. We're gonna try to catch a big one. Yeah, that's what we're wishing. Cause me and old Rusty's got that fishing affliction. Yeah, me and old Rusty's got that fishing affliction. Yeah. Man, and we've got it bad.
Just like me. Here, fishy, fishy, here, fishy, fishy, here.
Folks, thanks for tuning in to this week's episode of Fishing Affliction. And when we left you last week, there was a guy in the boat catching all the fish. And that guy was me. And I showed you a bunch of them, but I didn't show them all to you. So, let me show you the very last one that I caught in a row. And I think it's some kind of Fishing Affliction record, maybe 8 or 9 in a row. But anyway, whatever the number is, here's that last fish.
Turbo bass.
Dan's got another good one on.
Well, they're strong. Another good fish.
Oh my goodness, man. Another good solid fish. Boy, you're putting it on us. He's putting it on us, Charles. That's a good one.
Nice fish.
That's a real good one.
Isn't that great?
Whoa, 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 whoa. Put him in the box.
You want him in the box?
Yeah, put him in the box.
Okay.
We're getting ready to hold these first ones up here in a second, then we'll get some more.
Get some more. Okay. Good idea. All right, box it in.
You can put him in the left side. He's a little bigger. Charles, you want to ask Dan if he'll let you catch one?
Well, I'll fire him.
Hey. One more and it'll be the Charles and Rusty show because Dan will be back here swimming. No, that's a pretty good fish.
Quick release.
You got to get that quick release button now.
Yeah.
Disengage it.
Yeah. I caught one out of the Dan hole. The Dan hole. Got one on.
Pretty good.
Folks, we even asked why the big dog pops those fish in the nose when he catches them on a jig. Well, that's actually how he gets the jig free from the fish. And here's an example of that.
All right. All right, now this is what I've been doing that people think I'm abusing these fish, but I'm not. You take this thing and you... and you pop the head, and most time it'll drive the barb back through it. Sometimes you can do it with your finger. Anyway, there's another good little chunk. Not as good as the ones you've been catching, Dan, but he's still a good chunk. I'm gonna let that one go.
Catch you one, big dog. They're in there.
That was a fighter there, Charles.
Yeah.
Ooh, nice one, too.
That's a good largemouth. That one ate. Let me go back over with my crankbait.
We also get hit that thing.
Oh, look what a mouth on that fish.
Yeah.
Pretty.
Yeah. That looks like a good one.
Well, folks, there's one thing for sure. The old man of the river, Mr. Charles Sullivan, he's got an unbelievable touch when it comes to using that Strike King bitsy bug. and he sure knows how to catch them.
Alright, they eat the boat.
A bitsy bug fish. Buddy, I tell you what, that bitsy bug will catch them. Another good one.
Good fish. Good fish. That's a good one.
It's coming up. Oh, I don't got him hung good. Boy, that water's a lot clearer than you think.
It is clear. Oh, wow.
Ooh, I barely got him hung. When I see, well, might have him hung better than I think I do. Mm-hmm. Well, there's another crankbait fish. At first, I thought they'd got off the crankbait a little bit, but you'll get on the edge of a drop out in here, and you'll see them. I'll be out in there, you know, 13 foot of water or something, and a lot of our jigfish been coming 10 to 11 feet. And I'll go to about 13 feet, and I'll see some fish grouped up. And of course, when you're around these dams, it can be, you know, shad, it can be big shad, it can be stripe, it can be, you know, drum, rockfish, anything. But one of my favorite things to do is I'll back out and I'll pick up this big, this extra deep six, and I'll throw in that place and reel through those fish just to see if I can trigger them to strike. And that's what happened there. I saw those fish before I ever got that one to bite. Now I may not get another one to bite, but that one there loaded up.
Well, folks, while the big dog is trying to get one to load up down there in the wilds of Nickajack, let's go see this week's pictures from
In the Wild. Your pictures in the wild. Brought to you by the Boat Doctors. Before and after. Awesome.
Folks, we hope that you enjoyed a great 4th of July holiday, and here are some incredible, spectacular pictures from the In the Skillet gal, Miss Vicki Porter. She was attending a fireworks show and had her camera with her and took these amazing pictures. They're just incredible. And during the 4th of July weekend, the big dog and I, well, we went fishing. And here's the proof. A 6.5 pound largemouth and a 4.5 pound largemouth. And the big dog, well, he kind of gets put out every once in a while because he's not on this segment too much. So he wanted to make sure that you saw that picture not just once, but twice. And I thought, well, what the heck? I might as well be on there too. Well, folks, send your pictures in to pics@fishandaffliction.com. Be sure to visit our galleries at fishandaffliction.com. And maybe you'll see your pictures right here.
In the wild. Your pictures. In the wild. Brought to you by the Boat Doctors. Before and after. Awesome.
Kind of like this, all over, like that.
Maybe kind of like if you kind of steady, and if you pop it a little bit, you know.
There's no way I'm going to do that.
I believe it's like this.
Yeah, it's kind of like this.
It's like this. Then it's going like this.
No way.
Kind of like this.
The sexy swimmer, it's got action you can't believe until you see it.
I'm kind of liking this.
Got it bad. Want it bad.
Folks, if you've got it bad and you want it bad, you can own any episode of Fishin' Affliction for just a low price of $5. That's right, $5 for any of your favorite Fishin' Affliction episodes. And if you want them all, then we've got a great offer for you. The entire season one of Fishin' Affliction for only $19.95 plus shipping and handling. That's right, folks. All 13 episodes of season one of Fishin' Affliction for just $19.95 in a beautiful packaged DVD box set for only $19.95. Unbelievable, folks. To purchase this great deal or any individual show of Fishin' Affliction, go to our website at www.fishandaffliction.com to the online store for this incredible offer. Any individual show for only $5 or the entire season one of Fishin' Affliction for just $19.95. Fishin' Affliction for those who've got it bad.
employment trail for those who've got it bad. Brought to you by Fishin' Affliction.
Folks, here's the results from Flipper's Bull Creek Tournament held on July 11th, 2010. First place went to the team of Hawkins and Delk with 18.25 pounds. Second place, the team of Guffey and Breeden with 14.45 pounds. First big fish weighing 5.35 pounds was caught by Mr. Corky Chance, and the second big fish weighing 4.6 pounds was caught by Mr. James Anderson. That's some great fishing, guys. Congratulations to the winners, and thank you so much to Flippers. Folks, you can send your tournament results to info@fishandaffliction.com and be sure to check out our ever-growing archives at www.fishandaffliction.com. Folks, welcome back to Fishin' Affliction. And we're down there on Nickajack with the old man of the river, Mr. Charles Sullivan, catching a bunch of fish on those Strike King lures. I caught me a spotted bass, the big dog caught him a spotted bass, and then Mr. Charles caught him a good old largemouth. And folks, we had so many fish that it was time to turn them loose out of that live well in order not to stress them out. And after doing a little wrestling with them, that's exactly what we did.
All right, here's six of our first keepers this morning. We're gonna go and let them go rather than stress them out. And go ahead and get those six gone. And then we're gonna, all right, here's our next five. So now we're going fishing again. and we're all empty. A little bit abused by them fish. They were good and alive. Them aerators are doing their job.
That was damn funny. We beat up.
There's one.
Folks, those fish sure did put a whooping on us when we tried to get them out of that live well. And I just got tickled. Couldn't help it. As we watched the big dog catch him a Nickajack gar, let me tell you a little bit about the Fishin' Affliction gear list that we're using today. First, our 7-foot medium-heavy Kistler rod spooled with 15-pound monofilament. Our Strike King lures that we're throwing today? Well, for sure, we're throwing the Bitsy Bug and also that Series 6 XD. And keeping those live wells running and the trolling motor powered up, those ever-powerful Deca batteries.
Well, I am trying to get him loose, but it ain't working. I don't like fooling with gars. There we go. Man, I don't know if he hit me or I hit him. There's one. Boy, he was a little bit deeper. Don't know he's hooked good, yeah. Not as big as some of the others, but he's another basser. Another basser. Get that football jig, buddy. Little largemouth. Oh, he's been caught before, see? That little rough spot in the mouth. Looks like a decent fish there.
Fish. Well, while the big dog was steady catching those little fish, Mr. Charles was busy hooking in to a good old smallmouth.
Smallmouth.
Small jaws.
Yeah. I figured they'd be laying down there.
That's a good one.
Went my double tail again, I believe.
He hit me the leg with it.
They got to be 18 inches here, don't they, Charles?
Huh?
18 inches?
Yeah. That's about 15 right
15.
There.
15?
Well, as you can hear, the big dog's getting some help from another gentleman in the boat about the size of a smallmouth that is legal down there on Nickajack. But the big dog sure didn't need to worry about a size limit on these next two fish.
This is the littlest bass in history, I think. But he was a Kentucky. He was the right species, just the wrong size. You ever thought what them little fish went back and told their mother? Mother, it's right.
a giant throwing his finger in my mouth.
Missed a spot. He ain't happy. Oh, that's junk for the camera right there. Thank you very much. Missed a spot. Mr. Spot. We're getting a lot of these bites like this, little, I think it's little Kentuckys in this current. They're kind of, if you hadn't fished river lakes before, fishing river lakes is a lot different. You're dealing with a current, you got to worry about hanging up, and it's not as, where you may be doing more of a more movement. There you go.
That's good fish here.
Well, you may be doing a lot more moving. It's a lot more subtle in the river, as Charles is demonstrating. That's pretty good fish there, brother.
Wait,
Charles.
That's another smallmouth.
Is it? Good. Daggone.
Good fish.
That was a quick release button again,
that
wasn't it?
Good.
I think the instant replay.
I think that was a big spot, though.
Yeah. All right, shaking that head like smallmouth.
Well, anyway, we were talking about just drifting, and that's what we're doing. You can't really see it on camera, but there's a little bit of a swirl here, so the current's kind of backing up. And then fish will get in that little lull sometimes, and just, you'll catch them on a jig or even a crankbait or, you know, tube. Any kind of finesse worm baits like that tend to work the best on these Kentuckys.
Well, folks, you heard the big dog mention the word crankbait when fishing for these Kentuckys. And there's no doubt that he sure loves to use them. So much so that when he breaks one off, he goes a swimming for it.
Big Dog, that's wanting to get your Series 6 Strike King lure back bad. Don't be chasing the fish like that just because you break it off on a big one.
That water pretty cold, Rusty?
No.
No, it's warm, ain't it?
Way warmer than you think it would be.
Run away and jump that river up for you, it felt good.
I feel pretty good right now.
Well, folks, the good news is the Big Dog got his Series 6 Strike King XD back and also cooled off while taking him a dip in the Jack. You just never know what you're gonna see here on Fishin' Affliction. And you never know what Miss Vicki Porter is gonna be cooking next. So, let's find out what she's got cooking this week.
In the Skillet with Chef Vicki Porter is brought to you by Kleepy.com, turning your precious memories into video treasures.
Welcome to In the Skillet. I'm Vicki Porter, and today I'm going to show you a recipe for my Parmesan Pesto Pasta. Everybody loves pasta, and this one is so easy, I know you'll want to make it for your family. And now for the ingredients. You will need angel hair pasta, 1/4 cup of Parmesan cheese, 1/2 teaspoon of garlic salt, 2.5 tablespoons of pesto, and 1/4 cup of olive oil. First, cook your pasta according to the directions and then drain it. Next, add your olive oil, your Parmesan cheese, your garlic salt, and your pesto to the pasta. After you mix all the ingredients together, then you're finished and you're ready to eat this great pasta. This will be a wonderful complement to the shrimp dejeuners that I had on an earlier episode. You can find this recipe at fishinaffliction.com. I'm Vicki Porter. Tune in next week to see what's cooking in the Skillet.
Hey, what do you think about these? Shaw Grigsby likes these, but Denny Brower looks awesome in these. You know, a lot of people don't know that Strike King is the number one importer of packaged polarized sunglasses in the whole entire country. I've seen Mark Davis wear these, and I like them a lot. They're awesome. But you know what? Me? I have got to have my Monsters.
Folks, Folks, the Fishin' Affliction featured business of the week, well, it's actually a dear friend of mine, Mr. Chuck Pippin. I've known Chuck for about 15 years, and he is undoubtedly the best reel repair expert that I've ever come across. He has fixed several of my reels and made them better than brand new. And he is well versed in fixing all brands of reels, from Daiwas to Shimano's, Quantums, just anything that you have. Chuck Pippin is the man to take it to if it's not performing the way it should. Now folks, the Fishin' Affliction Business of the Week is not a paid sponsorship. It's just our way of saying thank you to these hardworking folks who provide a great service. So once again, thanks to Mr. Chuck Pippin.
It's time for Fishin' 101, brought to you by Fishin' Affliction.
Folks, welcome to this week's Fishin' 101, and as you can see, we're back down there at Nickajack with Mr. Charles Sullivan, the old man in the river. And there's one thing that I implore you to do, and that's what I want to talk to you about today, and that's wearing your life jacket. As you can see, we're right below the dam on some of these clips that where we're fishing, and it's the state law to wear your life jacket when you're in those type of situations. And even if you're not below a dam, where it's not the law to wear your life jacket, there are just some situations that I would implore you to do so. A life jacket is only worth it if you wear it, and that's the only way it can do its job, which is save your life. So that's this week's Fishin' 101, which is really more of a reminder. But please put those life jackets on, because it'll save your life.
Well, folks, as you can see, the rain started coming down after the big dog took a dip. So I grabbed the underwater housing so I could film with these delicate cameras in the rain. And what happened next? Well, it sure was almost the biggest one ever caught on Fishin' Affliction. Almost.
Golly Moses. I've caught in a while. And I'm just letting him stay down. I'm pulling out here in the middle, and I'm just letting him stay down until he's burned out. Dan?
Yeah.
Normally I am pulling these up and want everybody to see them jump and see how big they are, but this one here, I don't want him to jump again. That is a big fish right there. I guarantee you that fish is over 7 pounds. I guarantee you he's over 7. I guarantee that. Fish, get away. Shouldn't have that fish. Shouldn't have that fish. That was an absolute toad. That was a toad. I should have had it.
I tell you what, folks, that was an absolute giant, a true Godzilla fish. Well, after we got done playing in the rain, we decided to head back down to the trusty old dam to see if we could catch a few more fish before more weather came in.
I think that's Mr. Largemouth. Mr. Largemouth.
It's not a little one. Woo! He was bad. He was bad. Come here. Uh-oh. Well, that one's got a sore lip. A good spot. Good spot.
Pretty.
Yeah.
Might be a spotted bass, big dog.
Gotcha.
Ooh, that's a good jumper.
What is that, Charles?
A very nice spot.
Good spot. Nice spot. On that Strike King football-headed jig, and a rage tail.
And they are pulling current. You're going to have to go to the thing with it.
I got mine in the water, big dog. Right on them.
Folks, we so enjoy spending time with Fish and Affliction pro staffer and the old man of the river, Mr. Charles Sullivan. And as you've noticed, Charles has been sitting down as we've been filming these last two episodes of Fish and Affliction because he fell and hurt his knee while down there on the jack fishing off the shoreline. So let's keep him in your prayers so the old man of the river will walk the banks of the jack again catching those fish. But right now, it's time for us to think about heading out of the jack because we've got some nasty weather coming in.
Bad storm. Well, guys, it's a come time and every dog's life that they know when to walk and they know when to run, and it's time to run. That's nothing to play with right there. You have a nice lightning rod right here that will light up your life with this thing coming. That looks rough. Bad, bad.
Well, folks, the weather's starting to turn ugly down at Nickajack. We got lightning cracking, the wind howling, the waves are crashing on the shore, and it's time to get off the water, even if it means quitting.
You know, I really hate quitting.
Well, the big dog don't like to quit, and I don't like to run across the parking lot chasing all the papers from his front dash. Opened up his front door and blew everything off that dash at 50 miles an hour. Well, like the legendary actress Maureen O'Hara said, just a good stretch of the legs. Folks, join us next week for Fish and Affliction as we're back down there on Kentucky Lake catching some big old largemouth and watching the big dog hook himself. So be sure to tune in and you'll hear the big dog say,
I just made a bad mistake. I just made a huge mistake. Take that fish. I just drove this into my hand.
Folks, thank you so much for tuning in this week to Fish and Affliction. We sincerely appreciate your time. And thank you so much to our sponsors as they keep us going. Be sure to tune in next week to Fish and Affliction because there's no doubt.
Yeah, me and old Rusty's got that Fish and Affliction. Grab your hats, grab your baits, and don't forget your poles. We're going to fire up that old Ranger boat and head to the fishing hole. We're going to try to catch a big one. Yeah, that's what we're wishing. Cause me and old Rusty's got that Fish and Affliction. Yeah, me and old Rusty's got that Fish and Affliction. Yeah. Man, and we've got it bad.
Rusty's catching today.
I'll bet you anything.
Here, watch it like this.
Hit a striking bait. Let's go.
Ain't nothing safe around me.